Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Format Tricks for Exams. In this video we will see the different types of materials, wide variety of materials and its suitable sterilization method, and minimum 1 mark, maximum 2 marks are guaranteed from this topic. Okay, question paper setting persons will not leave this concept. Yeah, first we will see the hot air oven. So these are the list of materials. All these materials are sterilized by using the hot air oven. Okay, glass beakers, glass pipettes and any glass equipments what we are using in our regular laboratory, okay, are sterilized by using a hot air oven. See, keep in your mind, the glass item, any glass item will be break down in presence of pressure. See, in autoclave we are using a pressure, moisture will be there. That's why there was a pressure due to the moisture, and due to that pressure all the glass items will be break down. That's why don't go for autoclave. Okay, next is metal instruments, like a metal instruments like scissors and those instruments using for the purpose of surgery, surgical equipments, we are doing a sterilization by using a hot air oven. And for all these metals also, metal type of instruments also, don't go for autoclave. If you go for autoclave, what happen? The rust, there may be a chance of formation of rust, because the moisture what you are using in the autoclave, it may deposit on the metal items and it will be get rusted. Like that you can be remember. Okay, that's why we are not using a autoclave. And gels, ointments, ointment tubes also, don't go for autoclave. Okay, you go for hot air oven only, because the formulation, see here, gels, ointments, if it starts absorbing the moisture or water, there may be a chance of changes in the formulation. It will become a liquefy. Okay, that's why hot air oven is preferable. Okay, and powders. See, powders. Powders also same thing. Powders like a talc powder. This appeared in the world question paper. Talc powder. Okay, and baby, Johnson baby powder. Okay, and kaolin powder. This is also appeared. Kaolin powder, sulfonamide powders. Okay. Sulfonamide powders, okay, all these powder items, okay, use hot air oven, because all the powders having a flow property, we know very well. These are all the, you can be use it as a glidants also, but if you do a sterilization by using autoclave, there may be a chance of absorption of the moisture and it may lose its glidant property. That's why you have to use a hot air oven only. Next, oils, oil based injections, any type of oil items, okay, hair oil or whatever it may be, oil based injection, and wool fat, this is also related to oil, okay, and alcohol, you keep in your mind, alcohol we have to use only hot air oven. All these oil items, wool fat, paraffin, this is also just like a oil type, paraffin, liquid paraffin, soft paraffin, hard paraffin, these all oil items you have to use only hot air oven, because oil should, if it absorbs the moisture, there may be a chance of formation of the emulsion like formulation. Okay, so don't go for autoclave, use for all these items. All these items are appeared in world question paper, all competitive examination it appeared, each item was appeared. Okay, sometimes they will ask in an indirect manner, like a kaolin, directly they will give a kaolin powder. They will specify the name kaolin powder. So we will get confused. Okay, don't get confused. Okay. And see the autoclave. Autoclave, we are using a IV fluid. Here also, don't get confusion. Only IV fluids, not the IV set. IV set is we will use for radiation sterilization. Okay. And IV fluids. And IV fluids we will pack in a plastic bottle or nylon bottle, which are made up of a PVC, polyvinyl chloride. All these fluids as well as the fluid stored in a container. So all these plastic containers, we can use the autoclave for the sterilization. And rubber, see here, plastic is over. Now see the rubber, plastic and rubber, you can keep in a row. Rubber equipments and various parts of the rubber parts like rubber closures, autoclave is preferable. And vaccines, you can go for autoclave, but the temperature must be 55 to 60 degrees centigrade only for 1 hour. This is also appeared in the old question paper. Okay. And next is surgical dressings. Surgical dressings like a gauze, they might ask like a gauze. Gauze is like this cloth, bandage cloth like that, okay? A cross netted cloth, okay? That you have to prefer the autoclave only, surgical dressings, okay? Next is gaseous sterilization. Gaseous sterilization, we are preferring the EO, ethylene oxide. In my last previous video, I have shown all the sterilization methods, okay? Go to my previous videos, go to my playlists. There you can find all my videos in a subject manner, okay? Gaseous ethylene oxide. See here, I have given a star mark for this. I will explain you why I have gave a star mark for these two only. Powders packed in a plastic. See here, powders, we know that we are using a autoclave. That is powders either directly by keeping in a beaker or petri plate. You can be go for sterilization by using a hot air oven. But if the powders, if you pack in a plastic container, then you can use a gaseous sterilization also. Okay. And plastic dispensing, that is disposable syringe. Plastic disposable syringe. This is also gaseous sterilization is preferable. See here, star mark. Okay, why means plastic disposable syringe we can also do by using a method of radiation method. That's why I have given a star mark for these two only. You have a two options for this. You have two options for this also. You have a two options. Okay, and bottle closers, rubber closers, any closers like that. You can use a gaseous sterilization, okay? For rubber also, you can also use a autoclave also, okay? Next is band-aid. Band-aid, like a handy plast and all, you can use gaseous only. And band-aid cloths, okay? Cloths. Gaseous sterilization. When the cloth comes, automatically you keep in your mind cloths, blankets, pillow covers, okay? Gaseous sterilization only. And papain and pancreatin. This is also appeared in the old question paper. These two are the gaseous sterilization only. Because how to remember papai? We are using generally ethylene oxide for the fruit maturation. Like that you can remember. Okay. Fruit maturation, we are using a gas, ethylene gas. Okay. So papain and pancreatin, both are start with the same letters, PAPA. Okay. Pancreatin also, you keep the papain as a keyword. Okay, next. Water we can sterilize by using a ozone gas. That is a ozone formula is a O3, okay, H2O. Here O you can keep in your mind, ozone, O3. Okay, ozone, O3. And food, I wrote a food as spelling as a F-O-O-O-D, okay, O3 is there, O3, like that you can remember, ozone. And operation theater, BPL, aseptic room, which is completely free from the microorganisms, aseptic room, BPL only. BPL means beta proteolactone. It is a highly irritant sterilization method. And highly carcinogenic sterilization method, BPL, okay, but it is very effective, bactericidal and virucidal also, okay. Operation theater and aseptic rooms, don't get confusion between these two, okay. And hospital rooms and patient rooms, where the patient will be, here patient will not be there, office staff or any other rooms like record rooms might be there, okay, like that. Hospital rooms, patient rooms, you have to go for the Fumigation. This is also a very powerful virucidal and bactericidal method. Fumigation, formaldehyde, we are using for the fumigation process. Okay, and next, ionization radiation method. See here, syringe needle and blades, sharp metal objects. These are the sharp, very sharp metal objects. Okay, metal only, but sharp, very sharp. But if you go for heating or moisture, will not be suitable. If you go for heating of the sharp metal objects, the sharpness will be reduced because of the heat. That's why we have to use a cool method where we are not applying the heat. Here only we are applying the radiation method. Okay, and a plastic disposable syringe, I have explained already. Ethylene gas also we are using for the two methods. And sutures and ligatures. Okay, sutures and ligatures, this is also appeared in world question paper. All these are also appeared. Okay, sutures used to stitch the cut skin, whereas the ligatures used to tie the blood vessels, three or four blood vessels together, and we can be tied with the ligatures. Catgut, it is a type of suture. So that catgut, ionization radiation. And IV set, I have already told you, IV set, IV fluid. Okay, IV set is used for ionization radiation. IV set, see here, IV set, ionization radiation, II, like that we can be highlight. And adhesive dressing, like a sticking, okay, not a band-aid, adhesive dressing. And thermolabile substances, which are very sensitive to the heat, is called as a thermolabile. Okay, for here we are not using the heat, that's why thermolabile substances like vitamins, hormones, antibiotics, all these are the thermolabile substances. Don't apply the heat for sterilization. Don't apply the heat. Use the ionization radiation method only. Okay. Yeah, and come to the last, milk already I told, pasteurization. In my previous video I have explained what is a pos. We are going to kill the microorganisms, but not the pores what is present inside. Okay, but not the thing. Okay, and milk pasteurization. And beverages with glucose, electrical pasteurization. And culture media, this is also I explained, fractional sterilization method. Tenderization, 3 days we are doing, a 3 days tenderization method. Okay, in college level we are using autoclave for culture media. For the sterilization of culture media we are using a autoclave in our college level, but actually in a large scale we have to use the tenderization. Okay, and thank you, all the best for your exams. Okay, if you want to see all my videos, go to my playlists. After subscription, go to my playlist. There you can find all my videos in a subject manner. Thank you.